when two great talents find common ground, they can generate an immense creative synergy. And the composer duo known as Shiv Hari is a shining example, bringing together their remarkable abilities on the Santur and the Bansuri, respectively. Pandit Shivkumar Sharma and Pandit Hariprasad Chaurasia have been friends for over 50 years, and their repertoire covers everything from the classical works to soundtrack favorites. A recent concert in Cape Town celebrated their contribution to Indian music, and here are some of the highlights of Ragas of the Valley.
When Shivkumar Sharma and Hariprasad Chaurasia teamed up with classical guitarist Brij Bhushan Kabra to record Call of the Valley in the late 60s, they didn't know that it would become one of the most successful Indian classical albums ever produced with an international audience.
In 1967, two young Indian classical composers got together to create a musical work which would evoke a day in the life of a shepherd in Kashmir. That work went on to become an album entitled Call of the Valley, which has since become a milestone in world music. The Shiv Hari duo went on to become one of India's most acclaimed musical partnerships, and tonight's concert is a celebration of their work.
A quartet of leading Indian classical musicians was invited to South Africa by Inner Circle Entertainment to perform this milestone composition in concert.
Nisar, welcome back to Mela. Tell me about the Shiv Hari duo and what do you love about them?
They've been a legendary team of composers. Their first work together was Call of the Valley, which was released about 51 years ago, which is still the most sold Indian classical music album ever recorded. The music is steeped in the tradition of Indian classical music, and in there, I think it allows one to explore so many more nuances of the actual music, and that makes Shivkumar and Hariprasad Chaurasia just amazing composers.
What do you hope the audience takes away from tonight?
I'm sure many of them would be transported to the Kashmir Valley tonight. They'll hear those sounds, the beautiful Santur, which is synonymous with Kashmir. So I hope they have a lovely evening.
Well, I'm certainly looking forward to tonight's performance.
Thank you very much.
Distinguished musicians Shubhankar Banerjee, Sandeep Chatterjee, Santosh Sant, and Pandit Bhavani Shankar prepared for the evening's performance.
I'm already enthralled just listening to the rehearsal, and I cannot wait to chat to the artists and find out more about the men behind the music.
Having studied under Pandit Tarun Bhattacharya, Sandeep Chatterjee is now considered to be a Santur virtuoso in his own right.
Sandeep, welcome to Mela.
Thank you very much.
Tell me a bit about your musical journey and what led you to playing the Santur.
I didn't belong from a musical family. My father was an international football player, but he wanted his son should play something or to sing something. Then I started, and when it penetrates to your blood, slowly, slowly, slowly it increases, and then I had to decide that I should be a musician, Santur player.
What do you hope the audience takes away from tonight's performance?
We will try our best to convey the message to the younger generations or the newer generations, and hopefully people will like it.
Shubhankar, welcome to Mela.
Thank you.
What led you to playing the tabla?
I came from a musical family, so I was exposed to all kind of music right from my childhood. It's a long journey because I've been playing tabla since I was about 3 years old.
What made you want to pursue classical music over other genres?
It was, I think, destined, because I got an opportunity to go to Europe when I was 16 years old with one of the greatest musicians of our country. That took me everywhere in the concert stages in India and abroad.
How has the work of the Shiv Hari duo impacted your work?
A lot, actually. That is why today's concert is so much important for me here.
Santosh, tell me a bit about your musical journey and what led you to playing the Bansuri.
This instrument I play, Bansuri, is very much popular because of Lord Krishna. Krishna plays flute, and all the nature, rivers, mountains, even birds and animals were mesmerized by that sound. So I just attracted that because it has some magical power and spiritual power also.
How has the Shiv Hari duo impacted your work?
His music is divine. When I heard his music, always I found some divinity, some spirituality. So that's why I am bonded with that kind of music.
What have been some of the highlights of your career?
I play very big concert in the world. Myself and Pandit Shivkumar Sharma ji, Pandit Hariprasad Chaurasia, last 42 years back, we are playing together with top music director. I'm a two-time in my name in the Guinness World Record Book and Limca Record Book. I'm nominated for a Grammy Award also. and I have my name in World 10 Top Musician.
Call of the Valley features on the list of 1001 albums you must hear before you die, and local music lovers couldn't miss an opportunity to hear a live performance.
Indian classical music can be traced back to the ancient Sanskrit text, and it is renowned for its epic storytelling. Tonight we get to go on a magnificent journey as distinguished classical musicians perform Ragas of the Valley.
Originally conceived as a suite, this contemporary classic uses ragas associated with various times of the day to tell the story and evoke the atmosphere of rural Kashmir. When performed by world-class musicians such as these, each instrument has its own voice in the narrative, while also contributing to the overall sense of harmony and the unfolding of the theme.
Is like junk food, exciting enough to begin with, but not satisfying in the long run. Tonight was a completely different experience as the compositions of the legendary duo were performed by four very talented musicians. I'm left with a well-nourished soul and the music still echoing in my mind.